But a lot of coaches make this huge mistake, the highest return on investment for the money that they spend with you. If you struggle with getting leads, you should consider doing this, right? Like, think about this video. Once again, here we go. Know the name, my flow. Turn me up a little more. Number one, and this is often overlooked, right? We're talking about your content. So here's what I mean. A lot of people get this wrong. We are all content creators, regardless if you are putting yourself in newspapers, on social media, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, you know, LinkedIn, whatever the situation may be, you create content. Again, regardless if it's written form, video, audio, pictures, whatever it is, you are putting some sort of content out there, right? But a lot of coaches make this huge mistake, and literally in every single post, I see a pitch. I see a link that it says, book a call. I see something that it says, here's why you should work with my team. That's completely upside down. So, you know, don't get me wrong. You need to pitch time to time, but you do that strategically through paid advertising. Like if you're just every post, you just throw a pitch, it just won't work. So when I say problem solving content, is you need to think about the number one biggest problem that your customers have, regardless if it's business or life. Like it all depends on what's your business model, right? Like for example, if you are a health coach, pick what's the number one thing that you fix for your ideal clients. Not for everybody. You don't want to just think like, oh, I solve any kind of problem from, you know, the way that their body looks, with how they work out, what they eat, who they spend their time with. No, like you want to really focus on just one big thing, like what's, and even if you've been doing this for a while, you'll find this helpful because you can go back to your customer database and maybe just shoot an email or record a video and ask them what's their biggest problem right now. What are they struggling with the most, right? And a lot of people will say, you know, I struggle with this, this and that, but then you take a step back and think about what's the problem that you can solve for them that has the highest return on investment for the money that they spend with you. Ooh, I think, like, I'm pretty sure, you know, that's pretty deep. But think about that. If you want to have more clients, you should consider having more high-end clients. And if you do that, if you increase your prices, you may not even need as many clients. You just may need the right ones at the right price, right? And I'm pretty sure that makes sense. So problem-solving content comes into place after you do this step. So after you understand exactly what your ideal client's problem is, what's the biggest problem in their life or business, then start putting together a strategy. I usually like, every time when we consult with our clients, we tell them between 3 to 5 pieces of content, between 2 to 5 minutes long, not longer than that. And you'll just literally attack what's their biggest problem, right? Like, you'll just answer questions in that content strategy. Like you'll put together 3 to 5 videos between 2 to 5 minutes long each, and then you'll just answer the problem that you solve for them. So you'll start with, if you're struggling with losing weight, do these 5 steps and then you start putting them down. If you're struggling with having, you know, a healthy relationship, you should consider doing this, this and that. If you're a relationship coach, if you're a business coach, and you work with different businesses, you know, pick your industry. If you struggle with getting leads, you should consider doing this, right? Like think about this video, right? You're watching this video because you want to learn how to get more clients for your coaching business, right? Think about, you know, in your customer shoes, what they would watch. Nobody cares if you have a lot of certifications, and I know a lot of you may be, you know, hurt by this statement, but customers, they care about your solution in regards to their problem and if you can help them and how you can convince them by leading with problem-solving content. If you want to see the same blueprint that generated more than 7 figures in my own business and that my private clients are using every day to get insane results, you can get access to it for free and the link is right in the description below. So again, take a step back, understand what's the biggest problem that you solve for your clients, and then go create 2, 3, 5 pieces of content, and then lead with that. And stick around until the end, because you'll be able to watch another video that teaches you how to use those five pieces of content to actually promote them, all right? So I hope that makes sense. Number two is, now we get into a little bit of a more tactical part, right? So lead generation would mean how customers get your gated content. So first is ungated content, right? Like people will be able to just watch videos like the way that you're watching right now. But if they want to download something from you, where would they go? So you need to have a lead generation system to be predictable in terms of, you need to look at the squeeze page or the landing page or the funnel, whatever you are actually using, for them to be able to give you their information, name, email, phone number, messenger bot, subscription, whatever the situation may be. You want to collect data as early as possible in the process. You can only do that if you really lead with problem solving content, right? People will watch your content because it's valuable, and at the end you'll just ask them to download something. And of course, if that's related with what you just talked in the video, it's gonna be so much easier for them to do. So for example, at the end of this video, you can download an exact blueprint that you can go ahead and implement this. And that makes sense, right? Like you see the strategy here, and then you want to download the actual tactical, this exact process, right? So number two is lead generation, but you need to focus on, so this is basically where you start feeling that almost like the emotion of getting the high paying clients, because if you have the right lead generation system in place, you are able to convert these guys into actual high paying customers, right? And number three is your sales funnel. You know, there are so many different sales funnels that you can use. Now, yes, the lead generation process can be a lead generation funnel, right? I don't want to get into technical side, but of course you can use platforms like ClickFunnels, and I'll list in the description of this video a link to a lead generation funnel. If you want to download that in your own account, you can do that. You can get the 14-day trial, and then if you don't like it, you know, you can get rid of it. But if you don't have a lead generation process in place, you won't be able to have a sales funnel that can generate leads, right? Like for example, these two would actually work together, because you can have a lead generation page where people will download a PDF, a workbook, an ebook from you, and on the thank you page, you'll invite them to either talk to you over the phone, or maybe watch a video training lesson, or maybe watch a webinar, or you know, whatever the situation may be, or even sell a $7, $27, whatever option of this exact thing that they just bought, but more in depth, right? Like the example here would be the free plus shipping model for books, right? On the second page, you get invited to buy the audio version of that book, or you get invited to buy the video course. So you need to really have these things in place in order for you to be able to use the sales funnel, because that's the money-making machine. That is the place, and let me step back for a second. There's no website. If you've watched all of these three things, there's no website mentioned here. So you want to make sure that, you know, I'm not saying that don't have a website, because you can blog and you can write articles in there. But in this scenario, in order for you to actually generate clients, you don't need the actual website to be in place. You can worry about that after you get a few clients that you can afford, maybe hire a virtual assistant on Fiverr or Upwork or whatever the situation may be. You want to make sure that these two are connected together. And I'm pretty sure that even now, if you go back into your past, I'm pretty sure you've sent emails. Those emails can become blogs. Those blog articles can become PDF pieces. Those PDFs can be recorded as an audio form, and you can just give those away in exchange for an email address, phone number, email, name or messenger bot, or whatever the situation may be, right? So don't stress out on, oh, I don't know what's the lead gen process and things like that. Just allow people to download something from you. If you really lead with the problem solving content, people will just want to get more stuff from you because they see that it's valuable, right? And you can pitch, like I said, the pitch part, I guess the money part is right here in the sales funnel, not right here where you just put your links in, hey, work with me, here's why you should work with us, and book a call in your first post in the morning at 9 a.m. is book a call with us. No, that's completely wrong. Maybe those things worked like 5 or 10 years ago, they're not working anymore, right? Like people that get to your sales funnel, people that get to your lead generation, you can show them other content for them to be able to book a call with you or talk to you over the phone or whatever the situation may be, right? So I hope this makes some sense. Now, at the end of this video, like I mentioned, you'll be able to watch another 2 pieces of content. One will show you how to use paid advertising to promote all of these things. And then the other one will actually teach you how you can pre-sell a course before it's even created. So that's super powerful, all right? Now, if you like this video, let me know in the comment which of these 3 things you've implemented so far and if they're working and how they work. Or if you haven't, why? Let me know, because I really want to hear from you. I'll be the one answering back. Also, if you enjoyed this episode, let me know in the comments what are the actual things that you struggle the most with, and I'll make sure to create content around that. Don't forget, if you want to get notified, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell, or if you want all of these in your own inbox, go to clientacquisitionpodcast.com and you can sign up there. We also have a giveaway going on, so you'll love that too. All right, stick around and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care.